IT Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad announced on Wednesday the government's plan to merge BSNL and MTNL. According to him, the cabinet has also cleared funds to revive both companies.
तो पहली बात यह है कि neither BSNL MTNL is being closed, nor is being disinvested, nor is being hived to any third party.
Also, BSNL and MTNL will be allocated 4G spectrum at the cost that was set in 2016, and that lucrative VRS packages will be provided to the employees of the ailing telcos. The decision comes at a time when the state telecom firms are struggling to pay September salaries. In a move that will benefit 40 lakh people, the Union Cabinet on Wednesday approved a proposal to grant ownership rights to people living in unauthorized colonies in Delhi. According to Union Minister Prakash Javadekar, the proposal is based on the recommendations of a committee. Union Minister Hardeep Puri said that ownership rights will be conferred to people who are living in unauthorized colonies, whether it is private or government land. The move comes ahead of the assembly polls in the national capital scheduled for early next year.
Aaj cabinet decision hua hai, agla jo parliament session hai, which is I think starting on 18th November to we are bringing the bill. The bill is already been drafted. We will be finalizing through the consultative process. We'll bring the bill and DDA is beginning work immediately.
Congress leader D.K. Shivkumar has been granted bail on a personal bond of 25 lakh rupees by the Delhi High Court. The Congress troubleshooter has been in jail for 50 days now. The Delhi High Court granted relief to the Congress leader, saying that Shivkumar is not a flight risk. The judge also said that Shivkumar cannot tamper with evidence as documents are there with investigating agencies and there is no material to show he has influenced witnesses. The Karnataka leader has been accused by the Enforcement Directorate of moving a huge amount of unaccounted cash on a regular basis through Hawala channels with the help of three other accused.
In a surprise move, Bihar Chief Minister Nitish Kumar on Wednesday batted for full statehood for Delhi. Addressing workers of his party, Kumar also reiterated his demand for a special status for Bihar, even though the Modi government has already rejected it. The move surprised many as Nitish Kumar's JDU is a BJP ally and the comment comes ahead of polls in the state next year.
And when we come, we say that we get the title of Delhi as a complete king. जैसे हम बिहार को विशेष राज्य के दर्जा की मांग करते हैं वैसे दिल्ली को पूर्ण राज्य का दर्जा मिलना चाहिए और ये बात हम लोग हमेशा से कहते रहे।
The CBI has booked former Uttarakhand Chief Minister Harish Rawat for allegedly indulging in horse trading. The case is the outcome of a CBI probe into a video recorded in 2016 when the state was under president's rule. The video allegedly shows the Congress leader discussing money to win back the support of disgruntled MLAs who had crossed over to the BJP so that he could come back to power. The move comes after the Uttarakhand High Court gave the nod to the CBI to go ahead with its investigation and lodge an FIR against Rawat after the agency submitted a report in a sealed cover. Hindu Samaj leader Kamlesh Tiwari, who was murdered at his residence in Lucknow on Friday, was stabbed 15 times and shot in the face. The post-mortem report has stated there were two deep stab wounds on his neck and a bullet was found on the left side of his skull. Two main accused, Ashfaq Hussain and Moinuddin Pathan, were arrested on Tuesday from Gujarat. Tiwari was allegedly murdered over his derogatory remarks on Prophet some years ago.
With growing speculations around MS Dhoni's future in international cricket, newly elected BCCI President Sourav Ganguly dropped a massive hint about Mahi's immediate future.
It depends on him, you know. I've always said, even when I was left out and when the entire world said that, you know, he'll never make it, I believed in myself and came back and played for 4 years. You know, champions don't finish very quickly. I don't know what's in his mind, what he thinks about his career. So we'll deal with that. You know, he's one of the greats of the game. India is very proud to have MS Dhoni. Over a period of time, his achievements, is when you sit down and take note of what he's done, is you say wow, you know, MS Dhoni. So till I'm around, everybody will be respected. So that doesn't change.
NASA has found no evidence of Chandrayaan 2's Vikram lander in the latest images captured by its moon orbiter off the lunar South Pole region. On September 7th, ISRO attempted a soft landing of Vikram on the uncharted lunar South Pole before losing communication with the lander. NASA has said that it is possible that Vikram is located in a shadow or outside of the search area, which is why it has gone undetected. Actor and filmmaker Pooja Bhatt has opened up about her struggles with alcoholism and revealed that she has been sober for almost 3 years now. Sharing her de-addiction story on Instagram, Pooja said that if she can do it, others can do it too. She also added that people who are battling similar addictions should not feel alone. It's indeed a happy birthday for Malaika Arora. Arjun Kapoor shared a picture of him fondly kissing rumored girlfriend Malaika Arora with a heart emoji as the caption,